So what was the purpose of your research, and how did the country you traveled to meet your research goals?
So I'm a second year in the MFA in Transdisciplinary Design in Parsons Musicals and Design Strategy, and my focus is on transmedia as a method of storytelling to engage audiences, raise awareness, and challenge discriminatory social norms. So my research was focused on making advocacy media in an international setting. And I got to partner with an amazing organization called Nazdik that does human rights law in New Delhi, and help them with some advocacy campaigns as well as marketing for their organization. And it was really great to be able to work on the ground with them.
Okay. Describe a memorable experience during your trip.
The most memorable experience of my trip, sadly, is not a great one, although it's a funny story. On a Thursday night, I went to a Sufi Durga for prayer. They do singing prayers on Thursdays. And as I was approaching, these two guys came up to me, and I don't speak any Hindi. And they point at me and say, "Shoes." And I kind of look at them and say, "Oh no." And I know you're not allowed to wear shoes into the Durga, but these guys clearly weren't affiliated with the Durga. So I get in a cross-language argument about whether or not I can keep my shoes, and somehow lose the argument and my shoes in the process, and they push me into the Durga. And I'm there, and I know that these two guys have stolen my shoes, and I'm freaking out a little bit, but I listen to the music, and then when I leave, I find them again and ask for my shoes, and they look me dead in the face and say, 500 rupees. And I start yelling at them, but it's in English, and they don't understand me, and I have to barter for my own shoes, and ultimately ended up paying 200 rupees to buy my shoes back from these guys who totally scammed me, and I knew it was happening, and it was a crazy Indian story. Only in Delhi, right?
Okay, what are some recommendations that you have for future students who want to travel to the same country?
My biggest recommendation is to find a strong local partner. I was really fortunate to be able to work with Nazdik, and they were an amazing resource, and they let me work on a lot of spectacular projects. But it was really hard to get those connections from New York reaching out. It was a big challenge, but once I had Nazdik as a resource, everything went much smoother. So that, I think, is probably the most important step for anyone trying to do a project like this. The other thing is be ready for uncertainty. A lot of change happens. I initially was going to sublet from someone, and they canceled a week before, and so I had to scramble to find a place to live. My project changed about 2 times in the process of planning it. So the real world is a lot messier than academia, and I think you always need to be ready to move or adapt, and as long as you're flexible, you can make things happen. But be ready for uncertainty.
How did your trip complement your overall academic goals at the New School?
It was an amazing opportunity to practice some of the things I'm learning about and studying theoretically in the real world, and things are a lot more difficult to execute in the real world than we act like they are in academia. It also ended up getting me my first publication, which is huge for me as someone who hopes to be writing more and putting out media outputs. To even have that first article that I can point to in the future and say, this is the time I've been published at a national level newspaper is a really great career opportunity for me, and I'm so amazed that through ICI and Nazdik I was able to have that opportunity.
Thank you.